Warning, what you're about to see is the reason why Elon Musk did not buy Twitter. That's right, in today's video we are going to be creating a robot that is going to send messages to all of our followers on Twitter. Isn't that amazing? Imagine you had a button on Twitter that could say, send messages to all of my followers, and all of your followers get the message. Well, in today's video, we're going to be using a no-code, low-code platform from Microsoft called Microsoft Power Automate Desktop to build such a technology in, or such a robot, in probably more or less 5 minutes. It's going to be extremely simple. You have to be overqualified to do this. You have to have a master's degree in quantum physics, but apart from that, you should be able to follow along. Let's get started right away and let's start from scratch and create a new process. Once you have installed Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, you are going to be with this screen without any processes probably. So we are going to create a new process and we're going to call it Twitter Send Messages. All right, we are in a blank canvas. One thing to remember before building a process is that the idea for building any process is to do as little steps as possible with the robot. Therefore, we have to, we can log in inside of Twitter already so that we don't have to automate the parts of logging in. We can go to our profile and we can go to our followers. So let's go to our followers. These are our followers. So what are we going to do? We are going to extract all of our followers and at the same time, we are going to visit each one of their profiles and send them a message. So the starting page for our automation is going to be this right here. The link right here. So instead of navigating through all of these steps, I'm just going to get the link and start the automation with that link. That is going to save me a couple of steps, and the less steps in your robot, the more the less prone to mistakes it is. So I'm going to add the link right here and we're going to maximize this screen. So this is going to be our first action, is to launch a new Google Chrome. We can run this and see if it works just for practice or just to make sure that everything is working fine, that our plugin is connected properly. Everything seems to be working fine. So let's use the simplest way of using this tool for right now. And if it works, if it doesn't work, then we can change different ways. Now, remember another thing, there is many different ways of doing the same thing with this tool. I will always try to use the simplest way and then work our way to the harder methods. So what are we going to do? We are going to extract the name of each one of these profiles and then we're going to go to their page and send them a message. So these are all of my followers. Let's extract all of my followers. So if I select and hover my mouse over the followers, Power Automate is automatically going to detect all of the different followers and extract them for me. So I just have to do it for two to show it which ones am I doing it on. Now, a couple of steps have been generated and created for me. So I'm going to delete all of the steps that are unnecessary. So we have the first steps, which is to launch a new Google Chrome, and the second step, which is to extract data from the web page. It is good practice to add a weight. So in the actions, I'm going to search for a weight and add 3 seconds of waiting. Just to give the page some time to load, some extra time to load. So all the data is going to be stored in here, in this variable called output data, but I actually want this data inside of an Excel sheet. So with a click of a button, I'm going to change it to Excel spreadsheet and save. Now all of the data should be inside of an Excel spreadsheet. Let's run this and see what happens. Now, isn't this amazing? It hasn't been already a few minutes and we already created an automation that opens Microsoft Google Chrome and extracts our followers, puts them in an Excel sheet. So right now we are extracting only 31 followers. Why? Because we need to scroll down and scroll down and scroll down, but we'll do that in another video. For right now, we're just going to see how we can send a message to this 31 followers, initial 31 followers. All right, so the first part of our process is done. We got all of our followers in a in an Excel sheet, but we actually need it in a variable. So we're going to change this and put it into a variable. And after that, we are going to use a loop. A loop is going to allow us to send multiple messages to the same or to the users from the list. So let's add a for each loop. And the for each loop is going to cycle on all of the data from the web page. Simple as that. And in here, we're going to create all of the different steps to send a message. So let's go to the first user and let's open their profile. So to open the profile, it's as simple as following the Twitter profile and putting the link to their username. And then what we have to do, we have to click on this message. All right, let's go back to Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and let's use the recorder again. So we have to click on this message. So let's record and find this icon. So we're going to select the icon because we are pretty sure the icon is never going to change. So did we? We've had a little issue. So let's reset our process and let's try one more time. So let's click on the icon and we have created the element right here, SVG from the recording. Now, the next thing that we have to do is we have to send some text right here. Now, from previous experience, I'm going to save you the hassle and tell you already that it's hard doing it with the simplest way. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to click inside of this start new message, and then we're going to send some keys to the terminal, to the browser. All right, let's click on done and see what we have inside of our process. We have two steps, click on the icon and on the image. We're going to move this inside of our loop, delete the comments that were created, and we are ready to rock and roll on to the next steps. All right, so the SVG is the icon for the sending messages, and the div is inside of the clicking inside of the text. The next thing that we have to do is send keys. Send keys is going to allow us to send keyboard keys to the terminal. Therefore, it is going to simulate as if user is typing inside of the terminal. I'm going to change some parameters like the delay between keystrokes, making it a little bit slower, and also to simulate hardware keys. We're going to paste the text that we want to send to our follower and click on save. We are also going to do another few things. That means that we are going to add a few weights just to make it sure that there's going to be no loading issue, and that should be almost everything for our process. One last thing that we have to do is, I believe, add a navigate to or go to. Now, this is going to allow us to go to a different web page. So the URL that is going to be the current item. Remember that we extracted all of our followers. Now we're going to go to each one of their links. However, there is a little modification that we have to do. We have to copy the link to Twitter and add it to the current item. The current item is simply this right here, is their name, is the name of the person. So the name of the person is going to be added to the Twitter link, and that's pretty much it. We can almost test our process and see what happens. All right, let's run it, see how we doing so far. So it's opening Twitter, so far so good. That's the easy part. We are going to extract the first 32 followers. We're going to go to the first follower, so that part is working. We clicked on the link, we clicked in the text, and let's see if we are going to be able to add the text. We are able to add the text, and probably the next step would be just to hit send an enter key and send them a message. So this is the second user, and let's see if it's going to be working. And it's working also for the second user. Now let's see the third user and see what happens with the third user. Probably it's going to work. Obviously it is going to work because this is the RPA Champions channel, and we create amazing automations on this channel that never break. And as I was saying, this process has just broken. No worries, because I'm going to show you a little bit of bonus content, how we can fix issues like that. So sometimes the SVG button will not be found. So in that case, what is happening is that we are using the recorder and we are creating CSS or CSS selectors or ordered selectors. So if the order of this page, something changes, this button is not going to work. So two things that we're going to do right now, we are going to just spy this button one more time. And let me show you what we are going to do. We have an SVG tool. We're going to delete all of these steps. We are going to go to the UI elements, get the selector from the SVG tool, and go back to our initial icon, create a copy of this, and paste the new icon. So what is this going to do? Is going to say that once we go to this this step right here to click on the icon, if our initial button fails trying on a different page. So for example, on this page, it worked. It managed to click it because that was the order of the web page. However, sometimes pages on Twitter have a different order, two, three, maximum four kinds of order. So this was maybe the second one. So we spied this element again, and we got this selector as well. So it's going to work on this elements as well. However, in case all of that fails, what we are going to do is we are going to add a label. So a label is going to allow us to skip all of the steps and just go to the next page. So we're going to call this skip and save it. And right here in the SVG, we are going to go to on error and continue flow run and go to label skip. So what is this going to do? This is going to do that once we come to this step right here, if there is an error, if it doesn't find the button for some mysterious reason, maybe the person doesn't decided not to be contacted on Twitter, so they remove the button. So you can do that. And if the button is not there or any kind of error, we're just going to skip to this step and just go to the next follower and send the next follower a message. So let's try that one more time and see what happens. At the same time, we are going to open a small version of this and try to put it side by side. So one thing to remember is that we are sending keyboard strokes to the browser. Therefore, if I click around, this robot is not going to work. This is one of those robots that you have to leave alone while it's doing its thing. So if I, for example, and click here, it's going to start typing in there. Let me give you an example. So this was the page that previously didn't work. I'm going to click right here, and you're going to see that we are going to write right there. Therefore, for this robot, it is important not to click around while the robot is doing its things. However, we are continuing. So like this, we can continue and send just basically a message to all of our followers, informing them of any kind of news or information that we wanted. Also, if we had a list of other people, we could create an Excel sheet and send a message to all of the people that we want on an Excel sheet. Now, isn't this amazing, ladies and gentlemen? I have created this process, and I have created a copy of the code that you have seen. I have left the link down below. So if you want to get the code of what I have created today, please feel free to check it out down below. Thank you so much for watching. It has been an amazing thing having you here with me. If you have any ideas of processes that you would like to see, I love listening to your ideas and building the processes that you think could be useful for the community. In addition, I also want to thank you all for watching and listening. The channel is growing amazingly. So thank you all from the bottom of my heart, and I hope to see you in the next video. Awesome.